Everybody asks, since I don't want to use a Berkey water filter, what am I using to filter my water? Well, I am still trying different options, and I did try a countertop reverse osmosis water purifier. I'm about to let you know whether or not it passed my test. Hey everybody, it is Kim with GetGreenBeWell.com. One of the biggest questions I get lately is what type of water purifier am I using? Especially if you have seen my video saying why I don't like Berkey water filters, which is usually the to-go-to water purification system for most people. I just absolutely do not like it, will not use it, and if you haven't seen that video, I'll put a link in the description below. So I am trying to find some better alternatives. Now, keep in mind, I'm looking for a water purifier, not just a water filter. Those are two separate things. A water filter will get out like chlorine, bad taste, just general surface kind of stuff. A water purifier goes way deeper, gets rid of bacteria and viruses, parasites, the VOCs, like so much stuff that can be hidden in your water. So my most recent try is going to be the Aqua True Reverse Osmosis Countertop water purification system. Now, Aqua True does reverse osmosis. They have countertop and they also have under the sink filters as well. I'll just say off the top, I do really like this system. There are some quirks that make it not great for everybody. I'm not 100% sure that this is something that I would recommend wholeheartedly. And for me, I'm not gonna be keeping it for our family. There's a lot of variations in there though that might make it something that's great for you. So let's get going. So as far as it coming in the box, it's easy to unbox. Pretty much it is completely put together as it is. You just take it out of the box. You have the filters that are gonna be shrink wrapped, obviously for safety. You just put it on a countertop and it's really simple instructions. Just be sure that when you are trying to lift the side lid or the side panel in order to put those three filters that you're gonna have with the reverse osmosis system in, I was having quite a hard time doing it. The reason was is because inside it was taped shut. And I didn't know that because I hadn't removed these two tanks yet in order to wash them. So I did not know that. So just FYI. So once you have those filters in, it is easy peasy, y'all. I mean, seriously, then you just start putting water in the tank, turn the button on, and it's done. It is that simple. You don't have to prime anything. You don't have to put together anything other than installing the filters, which are super easy to put in. There's no like screws that you have to tighten and all this stuff. So as far as convenience of putting it together, this is a super easy system. So you are gonna have two tanks, and this tank in the front, I actually just ran a batch, so it is full of water. This tank comes up, I don't want it to splash. And this is going to be where your purified water goes in. It does come up so that you can put it in the refrigerator if you want and cool it off that way. There is a spout. Can you see the blue spout right there? So if you had it in the refrigerator, you could easily pour into a cup from the spout, and you can pour it from the spout here. I love the fact that you can actually put this into the refrigerator and keep it cool rather than having to transfer it to another pitcher if you didn't want to. You can buy another one of these so that you always have one that's filling and one that is chilling. I like that, see? Just made a rhyme. And I have to say, the water pressure on this is amazing. A lot of times when you're getting stuff out of a purifier or water filter, it can be very slow and kind of dripping. This is amazing water pressure coming out of that. This is the tank that you are going to fill with water before you start that reverse osmosis system. And that goes back here. So as you can see, this is a smaller system. It will fit under almost everybody's kitchen cabinets, except for mine. This is reality. And my kitchen cabinets apparently are shorter or closer together than most standard kitchen cabinets. I have about 18 inches max, and that's including underneath this lip for anything to be put there, like a purification system. So while this does clearly fit underneath, to raise this up, if I have this pushed back any further, would not work. So I would have to pull this system out to get that tank up, to get it off, to wash it, to rinse it, and to refill it. So for me, that's not gonna work because I would have to have it all the way at the edge of the counter. All right, so I have used this for quite a while. Let me tell you all the things that I love, all the things that I don't like. Okay, let's start with the pros first. It is super simple, easy to use, easy to install the filters. It is a small system. It is very quiet when it is filtering. I will insert some video here and let you know exactly what it sounds like when it is on. And then the filtering takes very little time. I have timed it filling this holding tank all the way up to the top, which is about 17 cups of water. That took just under 10 minutes in order to do the entire purification system to fill this tank. I have put less amounts of water in this holding tank, and it took about 7 minutes for purification. Now in the manual, it says 15 minutes for purification, going up to about 30 minutes when the filters need to be changed and are getting dirty. I have not found that to be the case. I found it to be much quicker. Now, as far as the taste, I really like the taste of this water. With the Berkey, I absolutely hated the taste of that water. This, I like. Like I said, there's no priming. You don't have to have a plumber. It's just really easy. So why would I not be keeping this water purification system? You want to know. And here are the negatives that I have found after using this reverse osmosis countertop filtration system. Okay, so I said that I had done a tank of water to show you. So I did 17 cups in here. There is a lot of water still left in this holding tank. And this filtered water tank that you drink from is completely full. It doesn't matter if you put in less water in there. It's just reverse osmosis wastes water. It wastes a lot of water. And I don't think people realize that if you can't actually see it physically happening. You've probably read about that, but if you have an under-the-counter system, you would never know exactly how much water is being wasted. This is a visual representation. There is that much water left in the tank, which is about 6 cups because I've measured it, that needs to be put down the drain or reused somehow else. And then that would give about 11 cups of purified water that I can use. But anyways, the calculations have been a waste of about 35% of the water that I put in or more. 35% of water is absolutely being wasted. And when I say waste, I mean that the water is in this tank and it is so full of the harmful stuff that you want removed out of your water that it should not be consumed, obviously. That's why you are doing a water purification system. But because that strength of contaminants is super strong in this water now, it might not be something you want to put on your plants. So you can't really reuse it in order to water your plants. I just don't think a high concentration of contaminants in water is actually good for any plants, indoors or outdoors. So over a third of the water that you put in is wasted. Now in the materials that AquaTrue has put in the manual, it says about 25% is wasted. Whether or not that would actually improve or get worse over time, I don't know. I just, with a good conscience, that's just a lot of water being wasted. All this minerals being removed and so much going on. You need to clean this at least once a week. Obviously, there's a big sign up here that says wastewater scaling risk. Because obviously you have the let me take this off, the concentrated contaminants in the tap water tank. So I can let you read that as you want. So you're going to have like a bunch of stuff to clean off. You can't just keep doing this for like weeks and weeks and not clean this. You're supposed to be doing it every week. That's just one more chore that I really don't want to have to do. Also, depending on where this is located, as you can see, it's like I kind of got to put it in carefully because of my counters. If you have a system like this where you kind of got to be putting it back and forth, it's just a lot. It's just trying to jimmy it out. Then you've got to dump it. You got to rinse it, which is wasting water again, and washing it. And you're supposed to be cleaning the filtered water tank every week as well. There's just a lot going on as far as upkeep and having to clean a lot of stuff a lot of times. Another thing that I don't particularly like, although not everybody's going to have a problem with this, is that you do have to fill this tank, which if you don't have it right beside a sink where you can pull the hose and fill it like this, then you need to physically take this tank off. Oops. And thankfully, when you lift this top, there is a handle. So you would hold the handle and fill this with water. But that much water gets pretty heavy. So if you have arthritis, if you have maybe some issues up here, like weak muscles or neck issues, and you're holding this and you need to, you know, pick it up, that could be a problem for some people. So this does get heavy. You can support it underneath, but you still got to be able to pick it up and get it onto the system and put it down. Again, that's nitpicky, and that's not a problem that's going to be for everybody, but I do know that a lot of you do have some issues, and with arthritis, you just can't grasp that much weight. All right, and then the final problem that I have with this particular system is that there is not a remineralization cartridge. Now, when I was asking my doctor specifically, like, what type of water purification system she recommended, she said reverse osmosis for sure, but it must have a remineralization cartridge. That is because reverse osmosis, also just abbreviated to RO, removes everything from the water. It's like removing all the bad stuff. And this is a really good purification system. But with the bad stuff, it's also removing any positive minerals that you might want in there. So when you have a RO system without a remineralization cartridge, that is a big deal because you are not having those minerals in water. Now, you can just get it in your food. You can get it in supplements. It's not that big of an issue, but it is just one of those things where you do have to keep in mind it's not being remineralized. All right, so that is my real life review of having used the AquaTrue reverse osmosis countertop filtration system. So it definitely is a good option for a lot of you, I think. It does take out a lot, like all the stuff that you want removed from your water to purify it, it does it. And I'm not going to sit here and list all of that. You can go on the website and I'll put a link to that below and see everything that it removes. So if you have a reverse osmosis system, especially if you have a countertop system, let me know what you have and whether you like it or not. Are you surprised by how much water is wasted with a reverse osmosis system? Because when you visually see it, it's a lot. That is surprising when you actually see it in place. And what do you think about that? Is that a deal breaker? Are you okay with it if it means that you have purified water for you and your family? So just let me know in the comments below. If you haven't already subscribed, I'd love it if you did. Take care, everybody, and be blessed. Bye-bye.